السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. On behalf of Markaz Sahaba, the voice of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we present to you lesson number 1267 of our daily nasiha and advice. Today, with the grace and mercy of Almighty Allah, is part 26 of our daily Ramadan series 1440. Our topic for today is, what should one do on the 27th night of Ramadan? Almighty Allah has dedicated an entire surah, chapter 97, for this particular night. And remember, it is the greatest night in the Islamic calendar. So after Maghrib, you then read 6 rakats, 2-2-2, Salatul Awwabin, any surahs you can read after Surah Fatiha, and you receive the reward of 12 years ibadat. Thereafter, Isha, Tarawih, and Witr. And thereafter, we should try and at least read the following. Try and read Salatul Tasbih, and our sins will be forgiven. Read 2 rakat Salatul Tawbah, we all are sinners. Ya Allah, forgive all our vices and sins, and make sattari and conceal and cover it. We all have needs. We want to come for Umrah, for Hajj. We want a flourishing business. We want our children to be settled. So read 2 rakat Salatul Hajjat. Whether you are at home or in itikaf in the masjid, go into sajda out of salat. Speak to Almighty Allah and cry to Almighty Allah on this great auspicious night. Thereafter, the greatest dua we should make is, Ya Allah, tawaffani muslima wa alhiqni bisalihin. Surah 12, verse number 101. Ya Allah, let me die as a Muslim and unite me with the pious and devout servants, Ya Allah. Thereafter, a person should always beg Almighty Allah, Surah 7, verse 151, وَأَدْخِلْنَا فِي رَحْمَتِكَ وَأَنْتَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّحِمِينَ. O Almighty Allah, include us in your special, special mercy, whilst you, Allah, are the most merciful one to show mercy. When we turn the pages of history, 26th of Ramadan, 762 after Hijrah, 26th Ramadan, 762 after Hijrah, corresponding to the 6th of August, 1361, Allama Mahmud bin Ahmed, who was known as Badruddin Aini Rahimahullah, was born. And remember that he is the famous commentary of Bukhari Sharif. His commentary is known as Umdatul Qari. The Hanafi ulama used it extensively because he was a very, very famous Hanafi scholar, and especially in Hadith, he was par excellence. On 26 Ramadan, 927 AH, corresponding to the 8th of September, 1521, the Ottoman ruler Suleiman al-Qanuni sent Bir Muhammad Basha to lay siege on Belgrade. This is in the heart of Europe. As the Muslim envoy was murdered there, the Muslims defeated them, and the first Jummah Salat was performed there. Subhanallah, can we imagine the Muslims in the heart of Europe and reading Jummah Salat, and this is already in the year 1521, September, Gregorian calendar. So always we should know that Muslims have spread far, far and wide. So when we learn our authentic history and not the propaganda the West is giving out to the people and trying to show that the Muslims were not there. Regarding du'as for Laylatul Qadr, remember senior Sahaba used to say 27 night is the Laylatul Qadr. Ubay bin Ka'ab radiallahu an, Amir Muawiyah radiallahu an, and many other Sahaba. So read this du'a. Allahumma innaka afoon tuhibbul afwa fa'afu anni. O Allah, you are of forgiving. You love to forgive, so forgive me. And you can add Allahumma innaka afuun kareemun. O Allah, you are of forgiving. Kareemun, you're very, very generous. Tuhibbul afwa, you love to forgive. Fa'afu anna, forgive us. If you read fa'afu anni, forgive me. Fa'afu anna, forgive us. We should be reading, our spouses should be reading, the children should be reading. For Allah's sake, switch off the satanic TV and all these sports activities, the World Cup, cricket and soccer, and whatever else. All these are satanic activities. Allah Ta'ala protect us from shaitan and his agents. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.